I am being pulled to this section over here, and they're telling me to talk about The Sopranos. Now, hold on. I mean the show, and I mean that somebody might have either had a walk-on role or somebody might have done something in some affiliated way with the actual TV show, but I'm in this section, not this one. Somebody on the side had a connection to the actual show, The Sopranos, in some way. Can you please stand? Can you stand? Hold on. Stand up, please, so they know where you are with the mic. Wait. There's a mic coming because I can't hear you. This to me would be, I don't care if they did with a caterer on the show, but there's some type of actual TV show connection.
Well, yesterday, The Sopranos, my professor in criminal justice, he actually, one of the parts where Pussy gets killed on the boat, it was actually his man that went in there because he was a state trooper and he worked undercover in organized crime. And he said that's word for word the way it went down.
Okay, so this just happened yesterday.
Yesterday, okay. In class, so, right
sometimes,
after class.
Sometimes at an event like this, they'll actually give the medium an article to describe, and then that lets me know.
Well, he has a book that it's called Blood O, I believe. He said that's his book.
Okay, but this is something that is a recent thing in your life. So what they'll do is they'll bring up something recently to let me know that I'm with that person. I've got a child who's passed, and they're making me feel like this is a child that didn't quite make it here. Or it either was a terminated pregnancy, it was a miscarriage, or quite honestly, a stillborn. But there's a feeling of a child that did not have the opportunity to get here. It's connected to Kathy, or the C or K name like Catherine or Kathleen. But there's a C or K connection that comes up with this. Does this make sense for you?
No.
Okay, then I'm not with you, even though the Sopranos thing made sense. Okay. All of it's going to come together in the same way. So if there's somebody else in the section that's got the Sopranos reference, and there's the reference to the child that's passed, and there's a C or K name, please stand. They're going to get a mic to you. If you can pass that mic down.
My cousin Vinny that lives out in Guard City, his friend was a caterer for Sopranos.
Okay. And the reference to the baby?
No, not really sure about the baby.
Nope, there's a reference to a C or K name who either miscarried, had a stillbirth, or there was a terminated pregnancy.
Well, he didn't... You had a cousin that had stillbirth? Yeah, but he's saying stillbirth. My cousin had a daughter, but she was born when she died when she was 3.
The same cousin with the caterer?
Yep.
Okay. Do they know that you're here?
I think so, yeah. Yeah.
You told them that
yep.
You're coming?
Mm-hmm.
And Vinny, is he named after his grandfather?
I'm not.
Do you know the family?
I don't know his side of the family. Not really.
How well
sure.
Do you know them? Like?
My husband's cousin.
It's your husband's side of the family?
Yes.
Do you know if there was somebody shot in that family too?
No. My father had a cousin
that was shot.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you guys together?
Yeah.
Can you please stand? Okay. Here's what's happening. I'm being told that someone passed through a gunshot. You know, and at first I had to stop. I'm like, I know this was a Sopranos reference in the first place. You know, it's like, I don't think they're, you know, I knew that they were completely separate. But let me say this. I've got your father who's coming through, okay? Dad is coming through. So I don't know if it's your father, your father-in-law. I have no idea. But I've got dad that's coming through. They're claiming the son is here. So I don't know if somebody lost their son, their nephew. I know you said Vinny has the daughter who's passed, but I've got a younger male energy who's coming through, which would be son, nephew, grandson. Where does that come up?
A couple of my cousins are dead.
Well, go to the family with the gunshot.
Okay, that's my husband's side.
So that's the same, but it's not that family. No. It's not Vinny's
family.
No,
it's
your family.
Right.
Okay, so we're gonna go to that family. No, okay. We're gonna go to the father-in-law.
Okay.
He's passed?
Yes.
Okay. And the alcohol connection, is that on that side of the family?
No, it'd be my side of the family.
And that dad also who's passed?
No, it'd be my mother.
But
yes, my father's passed.
I was going to argue with you. I'm like, what do you mean he's here? I'm like, your dad has also passed.
Yes.
And there's a William connection? That would be on your mom's side of the family.
The only William I know is my mother's cousin who's passed.
Which would be on your mom's side of the family.
My mom's side, right.
Hey, if it sounds better when you say it, I'll go with it. It's okay. but they're telling me to acknowledge your father, and they're telling me to acknowledge that somebody either passed in a coma or they had slipped into what would be maybe a medically induced coma. I don't know, but they're like not of clear mind, but they're still here. Yeah. and then they pass, and I'm supposed to tell you that their passing was peaceful, but there's the unspoken issues of what we don't get a chance to say and all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. They show me my wipe it clean slate, like let it go, don't hold on to that. I'm also getting the feeling of not a very loving mom. So I have to say I'm getting the feeling, your mom's passed as well, you said?
Yes.
Okay. I don't mean any disrespect to you, and I don't want to take away from your relationship, but your mom is coming across to me in a very bitchy way. And I have to say that the way she's coming across to me would let me know that she might not have been easy, and that she might have been a little difficult in the way she did things. And it could have just been at the end of her life. And I have to be honest and very clear, and people who know me know that I care about what I do. I'm very passionate about what I do. I'm not here to make you feel good. So if I see something as being blue, I'm going to call it blue. I don't see your mom as being nice. And she might have had some issues that brought that about, and there might have been some things. And one of the things that mediumship does is bring forth truth. And the reason why it brings that out is so you can deal with it, and you can deal with the reality of it. And if somebody had committed suicide in someone's family, then what we do is we talk about it. We talk about the energy. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
She's talking about suicide. So I don't know if her actions brought about her own passing, but there's an energy there who brought about their own passing. Do you understand this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I want you to know, we put the responsibility on that person, nobody else, okay? Because they're the ones who did it. And in order for them to grow through it on the other side, they need to be responsible for it. Your mom is telling me to talk about not being good enough, not feeling good enough, not being adequate. There's an insecurity that is kind of like fed here. So I don't know if this is how she felt or if her energy or actions made somebody else feel that way. But I have to say, she's bringing this up. Now, why do they do that? Well, one, because they see it as being their perspective and how they want to come across. And two, because they want to help kind of smooth out. If there have been some bumps in the road in the family in the past, mm-hmm. then they want to look at those bumps and say, okay, how can we make sure that the roads that we're going to drive on in the future are going to be smoother. The only way you can do that is through understanding. You understand the past so you can shape your future. And that's the feeling that they're giving me. I don't know if mom and dad lived together but really weren't together, but there's that feeling of like being together but not really together, or one passed way, way, way before the other, okay? Because mm-hmm. there's that disconnect feeling. Jenny, Jennifer, Janine, there's a J in name they're saying hello to. That's you?
Yep.
Okay. These would be your grandparents?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they're acknowledging you as well, and they're also congratulating on the baby. So I don't know if you just had a baby or if the baby, you know, is
number two. It's on the way.
You're pregnant too?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay, congratulations on the baby. They're telling me to bring up the month of March. So either there's a birthday or anniversary in March, or the third of a month is connected in some way.
My father passed away in March.
Okay, so this would be your dad's way of weighing in as well. Why do you think mom and dad would come through and bring out these things? Why do you think that they would harp on some of the stuff that would be kind of like, you know, itchy?
Well, probably because I wasn't getting along with one of my sisters.
Okay.
We hadn't talked in 2 years.
Okay. And do you think that maybe by shining a light on the past and understanding the relationships and the dynamics with inside the family could help you better understand the relationships of what you've created and that programming being passed down and how that's going to continue until you actually break that programming?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and this is for everybody in the room, by the way. Every one of you, every single one of you, I don't want to say is a victim. Every one of you is basically a product of your mom and your dad and their grandparents and their energy and that energy programming that's passed down. And hopefully most of it's good, but guess what? Some of it maybe not so good for you. And if you try to live your life based upon what you would think that they would want or what they think, not so good. So whenever somebody comes to me as a medium and they're looking at me saying, is mom happy with my decisions? Who cares? Are you happy with your decisions is more the answer that you should be looking at. Because if you're truly happy with your decisions, then your mom's going to be happy with your decision. And that's the feeling that I'm getting regarding your mom, your dad, and your family. So just be aware that as we're moving forward, just be aware of your past, those bumps in the roads, and some of those issues. And don't feel the need to perpetuate them. I think you know what I'm talking about, okay? Mm-hmm. They're telling me to acknowledge Robert as well. So I don't know if that's your cousin, but they're acknowledging Robbie or Bob. But there's a name like that as well. Mm-hmm. All righty? Guys, thank you very much.
Okay,
thank you.
Thank you.